Before we get into too much of a love fest for Eyes on the Prize here, I was reminded listening to these folks that there was a later Blackside series called I'll Make Me a World, which was about the African-American arts. And in that, there was an interview with a young rapper who complained that his parents had made him watch Eyes on the Prize. Well, they describe what school is. Our great American filmmaker, Les Blank, who did astonishing films about Southern culture and music, a critic from Variety. Les, let's hear it for Les. When a critic from Variety asked Les how he prepared to do his films, he said, I go down there and I get drunk with the people and we make the movie. And believe me, there were times on the road with Mike and Callie and Sekou when we sort of wished we were doing Eyes on the Prize that way. But it was the most excruciatingly well-prepared television I ever worked on. It was really astonishing, the thought and the care that went into it. So I want to do a little reading from putting this thing together. We were all in consensus around Henry's appeal to honor the foot soldiers, the fan ladies. Remember the ladies in church with the fans, the ordinary world parishioners, doggedly organizing, marching, demonstrating for months and sometimes years. Hampton himself transformed the convenient abstraction of hapless victims into a tangible flesh and blood army of strong, courageous, and highly effective political actors who forced change upon the United States. That was the genius of his vision. Henry said they were not people marching around waiting for white folks to come save them. They were people who led into the streets. They were the crooked timber of humanity, and he intended to pull them out of the background and into the foreground of their own history on primetime television. So what exactly was the history, and how exactly do we get it on screen? Thousands of successes and failures in the long continuum of liberation struggle spread across dozens of states and hundreds of towns from the dawn of the Republic to the present. We had to chapterize it, bound it, discard most of it, impose orderly narrative on it. For 10 days, the scholars, activists, and filmmakers debated, cajoled, ranted, and coaxed into being the practical framework for Eyes on the Prize. What is the prize? Whose eyes? What is the force of nonviolence? Who are the carriers of the force? Are we giving whites too great a place in this series? Can this series keep alive the transforming vision of a movement? Should it? How do we present Malcolm X? Can we Northerners depict the true South? All cautioned against the danger of leaving viewers thinking that everything ended happily after the Battle Royale in Selma in 1965. Vincent Harding insisted that our work was invaluable because a new movement must happen every generation. Claiborne Carson said, this is not about how we got things changed in the past. This is about how we get things changed anytime. The viewer must understand this is a vision, not a bunch of laws and programs. Without ever saying so, we would present the Southern freedom struggle as an operating manual for successful social change in the future. This raised the question, is it the job of historical television to drive partisan social movements? Henry was conflicted. His mission as a passionate African-American activist was often at war with his mission as a sober African-American producer of documentary journalism. All Blackside's effort was dedicated toward presenting accurate, nonpartisan history. But were we kidding ourselves? Henry himself had spent time as an activist in the 1960s. Some Blacksiders had gone to jail for the cause. Can you trust the partisans themselves to write an honest history of a partisan struggle? We spent the next decade sorting that one out, with Henry often taking the Jesuit anti-partisan stance. But we understood that many radical transforming movements throughout history have failed, their vision crushed by oppression or neglect, in part because storytellers of previous generations have failed to keep alive the transforming vision and the operating strategy.